Previously on Crime Story. You want to tell me what's going on, what story you're really working on?
I'll tell you about it later, Mike. Right now I'm in trouble.
Joe? Yeah, Ray. It's called a subpoena. For you, it's bedtime reading.
We are here to inquire whether individuals within our own government are involved in financial and business arrangements with certain criminal figures in an official capacity. In other words, we are here to find out if, in fact, the United States government has made an unholy alliance with organized crime.
To the best of my recollection, I never saw this Gavin in my life.
You're a filthy liar. Krinsky knew he was being followed. He wrote down the license plate numbers, and we found it in his notes. You're going to jail, Colonel, for murder.
Detective Indelli, what Ray Luca has accomplished is the formation of an underground empire funded by heroin.
Senator Gaspari, that is a preposterous allegation. You know, sir, you've done nothing from the beginning of this hearing but subject my client, Mr. Luca, to a series of malicious lies.
Isn't that so, Mr. Indelli?
Yes, sir.
Don't you think, sir, it's about time you put an end to this farce?
No! It's time we put a stop to the criminal elements in our own government.
Senator, you're out of order. And I think you're making unfair, unwarranted allegations.
Excuse me, Senator. Lieutenant Colonel Dance would like to testify again.
Lieutenant Torello, you're out of order.
No, Senator Baxter, you're the one that's out of order. Lieutenant Colonel Dance has confided in me that he forgot to tell the committee something that's very important.
We'll hear the witness.
Listen, Mike, Dance just blew the lid off this place. He told him everything. He spilled his guts.
It looks like we're going to finally nail Luca on conspiracy and importation of controlled substance.
I'll be there as soon as I can.
Right.
It's been alleged that you're an associate of Jorge Sintero and have been smuggling heroin from Mexico into the United States.
I refuse to answer, Senator, under my Fifth Amendment privileges.
I'd like an answer, Mr. Luca.
Yeah? Well, that's your problem.
The President has requested our presence immediately. This hearing stands adjourned until further notice.
What the hell is this? What's going on?
Tonkin. Whatever the hell that is.
It's a military emergency, Mike. Vietnam.
Vietnam. Yeah.
Hey, boy, you want a margarita or something, huh?
Gentlemen, here are your new credentials.
It's pretty fast work.
Well, Vegas isn't the only town where you can call in a marker. From now on, this unit is assigned to the Bureau of Narcotics and Dangerous Drugs.
Mom would be proud.
Thanks, Pat.
Mike, how did you know that Luca was on his way to Latin America?
We have a mole inside of his organization.
I want to make something clear. These badges may mean something in this country, but when you hit Latin America, you are on your own.
It's the way we like it.
Done together. It's hotter in Vegas in July.
Man, this is supposed to be winter.
Yeah, I'd like to have the soft drink monopoly in this country.
I'd settle for a six-pack, a hammock, and an ocean breeze.
Flight was a little bumpy.
Wasn't exactly a luxury liner. Look, we're supposed to see Colonel Santos at the security police.
Not now. I got a message from Ambassador Morgan. He wants to see you ASAP.
We'll see Santos first. We'll play politics later, okay?
Lieutenant.
Please, Santos first, all right?
How much foreign aid we pouring into this country?
Millions.
Yeah, where's it going? I bet you Luca doesn't live like this.
No, he lives in the lap of luxury.
Not for long, he won't.
All the paperwork on Luca is in order, Colonel. We had the extradition papers and the warrant cleared through your embassy before we left the States.
Yes? I see no problem, Mr. Torello.
Lieutenant Torello.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant Torello. When would you like to serve this?
Right away. Luke has gotten away from us before. We'd like to get him on a plane and back to the States tomorrow.
Okay. Then let's go. This way, gentlemen.
I don't want to know about what you can't do. Those planes leave Hong Kong monsoon or not. Yeah. Yeah, and listen. You get me Chen in Geneva. Tell him to call me at about 2 o'clock my time. Put Ernie Hammer up for it.
Hey, boy.
Welcome to Latin America, Torello.
You're getting too much sun, Ray. Getting all burnt up. You're starting to look like a prune.
Let me guess. This is a warrant for my arrest and extradition. David?
I'm sure they're in order. There's just one thing.
There's no one thing about it. Pack a bag, Struts.
Hey, Torello. I guess you were in a hurry to come here from the airport, huh? You didn't stop at the embassy?
Ambassador Morgan, he was going to tell you.
This country's extradition treaty with the United States has been suspended. Mr. Luca's going nowhere.
Call Ambassador Morgan. He'll tell you the same thing.
Call him.
I'm afraid he's right, Lieutenant Morgan.
I can go anywhere, anytime I want, but I like it here. Now get out of here, Torello, before I have Santos arrest you for trespassing.
Mr. Ambassador, I didn't come all of this way to land a beach.
Lieutenant, if you'd only listened to Jenkins, this entire embarrassing episode could have been avoided.
Who cares about being embarrassed?
I do. And as long as I represent the best interests of our country here, you'll listen to me.
I'm a policeman, not a diplomat.
Well, you policemen made the trip for nothing because you can't have Ray Luca. He told you the truth. Colonel Dance is dead.
With the help of some of his friends.
It's not important what you think. What matters is preserving a strong relationship with President Torres. He's the first head of state in a lifetime that's lasted more than a month. And he's taken a firm stand against the rebels.
Look, I
don't... So we need his support.
I don't care about all of that stuff. All I care about is Ray Luca. Now, what about it?
Ray Luca's a guest in this country.
Come on, this guest is an international gangster, a drug dealer, an illegal arms merchant, and every other damn thing.
In the big picture, Luca's inconsequential. To these people here, he's a legitimate businessman. I've instructed Jenkins to make arrangements for your departure. You'll be leaving in the morning, so I suggest you get some rest.
Hold on 1 minute. I am not going anywhere. And if you don't listen to me, I'll go right to the president.
Out of the question.
Well, then who's the chief cop around here?
For the Minister of the Interior, Esteban.
Well, then I'm going to see him.
But you can't. There's protocol.
Listen, Mr. Ambassador, either you arrange for a meeting
or I'm going to do something to really embarrass you. Believe me when I tell you that.
Lieutenant Torello, welcome.
Thank you, Minister. Thank you for taking the time to see me. Yes.
May I introduce my assistant, Maria Flores.
How do you do?
My pleasure. Are you enjoying your visit?
We're not here on vacation. This is my partner, Sergeant Danny Krychek.
Nice to meet you, Sergeant.
I'll get right to the point, Minister. I won't take up too much of your time. We think that you have a major problem with Ray Luca here in your country.
I don't understand.
Well, if you don't know who and what Ray Luca is, I'll take the time to clue you in, and then I'll take him off your hands.
No, we can hardly ask Senor Luca to leave the country. He's a great benefactor.
Yes, he's good for our country, for commerce. He brings in business, gives our people jobs. And he's building a new container facility at the port, agricultural facilities in the rainforest.
But it's all a cover-up, don't you understand that?
Lieutenant, forgive me. We know there are problems here, but we have no proof that Senor Luca is involved.
Well, we'd like to look into that ourselves.
How can we allow you to do that?
By you saying yes. I don't care how many improvements Luca makes here. I don't care how many factories he builds for you. The truth is simple. You're letting a major drug dealer operate out of your country.
He's going to run a very large airmail cartel from here. He'd be very powerful, and he'll try to run your country for you.
Oh, really?
Yes, really. And when he's through, he's going to strip the country bare and ship the big money right out of here.
That's ridiculous.
No, it's the truth.
The truth, Lieutenant, is we control our own destiny, not Ray Luca, and not you. We don't let other countries' policemen do whatever they want. I will hear no more of this. Good day to you both.
Las Vegas.
Well, I'm Sonia, and this is my place. Welcome.
Hello, Sonia.
You guys cops?
How can you tell?
Well, we get two kinds of people in this place, either cops or crooks. Now, this one has an honest face. But the rest of you guys, I hate
Chihuahua. I hate Chihuahua. Wow.
Figured out what we're going to do about Luca yet, Mike?
I still like plan B. Shoot him.
And move into his house.
Keep the girls.
Not spaghetti and meatballs, huh?
Nah.
I'll tell you what we're gonna do. What we're gonna do is discover the location of his lab, and then we're gonna destroy his entire drug operation.
That sounds great. Mm. How are we gonna do that?
I have absolutely no idea.
Do you like our local cuisine, Mr. Luca?
Hey, boss, I don't know what they call this, but it's still a steak. And I'll tell you something, it's plenty tough.
You want to fly home so you can have a cheeseburger?
No. I guess this is just fine.
Esteban, I'd like to make Maria an offer. How would you like to come work for me, Maria?
That's a good idea. You're a lot better looking than I am.
I'm afraid Maria is much too loyal to leave me. Hey, Maria.
How about if I pay you twice what Esteban is paying you?
What makes you think I can be bad?
Is she kidding?
Do you know, Mr. Luca? Sometimes I feel like I am already working for you.
But you are. What's with Torello?
I have been informed that President Torres has not yet taken action to expel Torello and his friends.
Thank you.
do, Senor Luca, is force Torello out of this country myself, would you like me to declare a national emergency?
What is he, a comedian?
Oiga, me, esto no es ningún chiste, ¿oyó?
Senor Luca, you run a business, but I run a country. How would it look in your newspapers if I expelled Lieutenant Torello?
I don't care how it looks. I want him out now.
Boss, not now. Not now.
Buenos días.
What do you want?
The same thing as you, Lieutenant. I am a U.S. Customs agent.
Get all the way, Allahan?
Yes. Girl checks out. Says she's been a custom agent for about a year.
A year? See, for a professional, undercover work is dangerous. But for a rookie, this is a hell of an assignment.
Why is she doing it, Mike?
I asked her, she told me to mind my own business. I don't care what Hallahan says, we absolutely do not trust anybody down here. Do you understand me?
Well, you know this honest drug cop, Ortega? You should check him out.
Right.
Miguel, you have a telephone call. It's a woman.
What can I tell you, boys?
Small-time pigs that work in this country. They're afraid, Ray. They're afraid we'll move in and take over the business. So they strike.
Then, we should have a meeting. To let them know there's enough for everyone. I have no interest in your business.
Así es que no tengo interés en tus negocios.
None.
Ninguno.
But you must let me operate my business.
Pero ustedes deben dejarme operar.
Without interference.
Sin interferencia.
¿Y qué garantía tenemos nosotros de que trabajaremos sin ninguna interferencia?
And what guarantees do we have that you will let us operate without interference?
Wrong question.
Pregunta equivocada.
¡Traidor! ¡Cerdo! ¡Perro!
Maria's tip was right on the nose.
We're a little late.
We have been watching them for months. This meeting gave us the opportunity we had been waiting for.
How did you learn of the meeting?
We had an agent buried deep in their organization.
Colonel Santos, congratulations. We were just wondering if it's a custom in your country for dope dealers to get together for Sunday afternoon picnics.
Our American friends who had come to show us how to rid our country of drug dealers. Capitan Ortega, listen carefully. I'm sure Lieutenant Torello will have many suggestions for you. Vámonos.
Wait, is that the same Ortega Maria told us about?
We're gonna find out. Let's go. Thank you for coming. Mm-hmm. I hear that you're an honest man.
From whom you hear that?
That's my business. Are you an honest man?
Why would I risk coming here? Thank you. Listen, Santos was lying. We had no informant among those drug dealers.
It's obvious that Luca had him killed. It's his style. He doesn't like competition.
Mm-hmm. What can I do for you?
You can help me eliminate Luca one way or another.
Just like that, huh?
Now, if it was just like that, he'd already be a memory. Mm. Salud.
Salud.
Damn it.
Shh, keep it down, will you?
These things are making a meal out of me.
It's the way of the jungle, senor. Eat or be eaten.
Yeah. Well, these things are prehistoric. They're not ants. Look at the size of these things.
The drugs should have been here by now. Perhaps your information is wrong.
My information is not wrong.
If I knew who your source was, I might be more confident.
Would you tell me who your informants are?
I'm wounded, senor. You don't trust me?
About as much as you trust me.
Hey, Mike, three trucks.
Right to Luca's lab.
Yeah. It's these damn roads. I can't see around a corner. I can't use the headlight.
Just don't lose the damn truck.
Hey, Mike.
We're missing a truck.
Behind us! Behind us!
Score. Jackpot. morphine base.
So how is this place? There aren't too many here since my headquarters. One never knows who to trust. Isn't that right, Lieutenant? It is much more private.
All right, ask him where the trucks were headed.
¿Quieres saber dónde estaban escondidos los camiones?
No lo sé.
He doesn't know.
Tell him I think he's lying.
Dice que eres un mentiroso.
Es que es un hijo de puta.
What did he say?
Something very uncomplimentary about your mother.
Oh, yeah? Well, you tell him that if he doesn't tell me what I want to know, he's not going to see his mother.
Dice que si no le dices lo que quieres saber, tú no vas a ver a tu mamacita.
Mira cómo estoy temblando.
What did he say?
He says who quivers in his boots. Señor Torello, a moment, please. Forgive me, señor, but you are in America. There could be questions about any confession you might obtain. I would prefer to question him alone. Trust me.
My mother, huh?
Go check out the truck.
Are you sure about this guy?
Ortega? Yeah, I think he's all right.
Mira. Mira. Te voy a tener aquí por tres días. Después, voy a decir que eres un maldito soplón. Y después, te voy a dejar ir. Te vamos a colgar del cuello, ¿sabes? ¿Entendiste? ¡Del cuello!
What do you think?
I don't know.
Santos?
I said I don't know.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
You don't have to explain, I understand. This is a difficult business, huh? I've had something else. Something very big was planned for tomorrow night, but has been canceled because you seized the truckload of heroin. You have to be very careful, Michael. I tried to find out more.
Tomorrow night?
Yeah, tomorrow.
What about tonight?
Tonight?
Yeah, tonight, now, tonight.
Why?
Well, I don't know why. I have no reason.
There's no reason for love and every reason for love.
Who said that?
My father.
Well, you should always listen to what your father says. The truck we got was full of heroin, just like you said it would be. You shouldn't stay here. It's too dangerous.
But you didn't find the lab.
No, but we will. Ortega's questioning the driver right now. I'm laying odds by tomorrow morning we'll know where the lab is, and you shouldn't stay here. It's a little dangerous.
I had to know what happened.
Still, it's a little
What's
dangerous.
That? The tough Chicago cop is worried about me, huh?
Well, yeah, a little bit.
That's nice. No one has worried about me for a long time. Thanks.
Sorry.
Look at you. You have a kind face when you smile. You should do it more often.
I'll try to remember that. Who is it?
It's Joey. Mike, we may have a problem.
Trust him after all. Let's cut him down.
was very good of you to come. I know your schedules were full.
Quite right, Mr. Morgan. But President Torres insisted, as a gesture of friendship. After all, cooperation is vital to everyone's national interest. I'm just disappointed that such a sad occasion is the reason for our meeting. Captain Ortega's death is so tragic.
A complete shock.
And President Torres has instructed me to tell you we will continue the struggle against drug production and do everything we can to find the killer of Ortega and bring him to justice.
Who are you kidding?
Just what do you mean, Lieutenant?
What I mean is that this is the most corrupt government on Earth.
Lieutenant Torello.
Well, come on. Luke is living here like Napoleon in exile. A drug dealer escapes prison and his captor winds up dead in his place? Wake up, will you?
We will find the killer.
No, you won't, because you don't want to.
You are his subordinate.
And you're a thief. Torello!
Lieutenant Torello, you are no longer a guest in this country. You'll get a formal revocation of the visas within 24 hours. Good day.
Congratulations.
Somehow I'm not sorry.
It's their country, Torello.
No, it isn't. They just rent it to Ray Luca.
Couldn't sleep?
It's too bad.
What's wrong, Mike?
I'm worried about you.
About me, Russ?
How about you? If Luca ever
I'm very careful.
And he's a very, very dangerous man, Maria, believe me.
We are in business together, Torello. And risks are part of the game. What that matters now is that we find the location of Luca's drug lab. Michael. Come to bed.
From me?
I don't want anything. I don't know why I stay with you. Perhaps I like you. Esteban is waiting for me.
Why are you doing this?
It's my business.
When me and my guys take risks based on information that you provide, it becomes my business.
All right. All right, Michael. When my father was the finance minister of this country, he tried to do the right thing for our people. But Esteban had him killed. I should have killed Esteban a long time ago. But I couldn't do it. I can't do it. So, I will do what I have to do to stop him. Up to and including sleeping with him, if that's what it takes.
Thank you. llama... Hace 20 minutos así.
¿Nada más? Fíjate que me dieron una botella de champán. Pero si es francesa, ¿no puedo? Oh, no, 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 la amiga es la hermana de la...
Sí, tiene alcohol, me gusta.
Ay, no, ¿te gusta el tequila? No te asusta.
Good evening, Mr. President. It's a fine evening, isn't it?
What is this, Lieutenant? What do you think you're doing?
Oh, we're burning some heroin that was being smuggled out of your country before we got to it. Thanks to the fine cooperation of Colonel Santos and the police. This bonfire is a testimonial to our joint effort on the war on drugs. Would you like to come down and see it?
No, no, no. You prove your point.
Yes, we did, Mr. President.
I got that one.
Great stuff. Great stuff.
$500 kilos. Up in flames just like that.
I don't understand it, Luca.
I'm not paying you to be educated, Esteban. I'm paying you for protection.
Maybe I understand.
Enlighten us.
Just the obvious. There must be a leak.
The Titanic had a leak. This was an abyss.
Yes, and it threatens the entire operation.
Hey, boss, what's an abyss?
The space between your ears. Someone must have an idea who it is.
I think I do.
Are you sure?
That's what he said.
Are you sure now?
And he said he'll be there. We've got him, Mike. We've got Luca in the light. Stop it, Mike. You almost made me forget.
Forget what?
Just follow the dotted line, and Ray Luca is out of business.
His lab? How did you find out where it was?
I overheard Santero talk to Esteban. I have to go now. I don't want to be missed.
Be careful, eh?
Yeah. We'll see what is over.
You can count on it.
Déjenla aquí y esperen.
So, you've been feeding information to your boyfriend. Loose body, loose lips, huh?
Really?
Why did you do this to me?
You know why, you pig.
I thought you came to me for what I gave you, not because of your father. He was a problem. I had no choice.
Boss, what do you want me to do with
her? Relax, Polly. It's your call, Santos. You're more familiar with the local customs down here than I am.
I think I give her to my two men as a present. Then they can kill her.
Llévensela.
She probably gave the lab to Torello. Let's get out of here, Polly.
Thank you.
alto, paren el coche.
The Duff Chicago Cove is worried about me, huh?
Yeah, a little bit.
That's nice. No one has worried about me for a long time. Thanks.
Sorry.
Look at you. You have a kind face when you smile. You should do it more often.
I'll try to remember that.
Had a setback.
A setback. Torello damn near puts me out of business, and you call it a setback.
Mr. Luca, I told you my concern is not yours, but my country. So as long as you serve our interests, you're welcome to stay here. But if you think I'm going to sacrifice our standing for you and your business, you are wrong, senor. If you're having problems with Lieutenant Torello, I suggest you do something about it yourself. I'd expect nothing from this presidential office.
What do you think you are doing? What are you doing?
It's easy. Electing a new president.
I don't understand, Luca.
Figure it out, Esteban. You're the new president.
What?
And your first order of business is arrest Torello and his men for the murder of Maria Flores. You understand?
Next week on Crime Story.
They're idiots! Look, you got one job and one job only, Esteban. You get Torello, you get him, you lock him up, and you give me the key.
I'm
What makes you think that I need you to help me get rid of Ray Luca?
Luca's already killed most of your competition.
There's a lot more at stake here than finding Mike Torello.
Yeah? Like what?
Welcome to hell, senor.
Do you know, Mr. Luca? Sometimes I feel like I am already working for you.
But you are. What's with Torello?
I have been informed that President Torres has not yet taken action to expel Torello and his friends.
Torello out of this country myself, would you like me to declare a national emergency?
What is he, comedian?
Oiga, me esto no es ningún chiste, ¿oyó?
Señor Luca, you run a business, but I run a country. How would it look in your newspapers if I expelled Lieutenant Torello?
I don't care how it looks. I want him out now.
Boss, not now. Not now.
Buenos días.
What do you want?
The same thing as you, Lieutenant. I am a U.S. Customs agent.
Get all the way, Allahan?
Yes. Girl checks out. Says she's been a custom agent for about a year.
A year? See, for a professional, undercover work is dangerous. But for a rookie, this is a hell of an assignment.
Why's she doing it, Mike?
I asked her. She told me to mind my own business. I don't care what Hallahan says. We absolutely do not trust anybody down here. Do you understand me? Well, you know this honest drug cop, Ortega? You should check him out.
Right.
Miguel, you have a telephone call. It's a woman.
What can I tell you, boys?
So strong, and as I stood.
water in Vegas in July.
Man, this is supposed to be winter.
Yeah, I'd like to have the soft drink monopoly in this country.
I'd settle for a six-pack, a hammock, and an ocean breeze.
Flight was a little bumpy.
It wasn't exactly a luxury liner. Look, we're supposed to see Colonel Santos at the security police.
Not now. I got a message from Ambassador Morgan. He wants to see you ASAP.
We'll see Santos first. We'll play politics later, okay?
Lieutenant.
Please, Santos first, all right?
How much foreign aid we pouring into this country?
Millions.
Man, where's it going? Bet you Luca doesn't live like this.
No, he lives in the lap of luxury.
Not for long, he won't. All the paperwork on Luca is in order, Colonel. We had the extradition papers and the warrant cleared through your embassy before we left the States.
Yes? I see no problem, Mr. Torello.
Lieutenant Torello.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant Torello. When would you like to serve this?
Right away. Luca's gotten away from us before. We'd like to get him on a plane and back to the States tomorrow.
Okay. Then let's go. This way, gentlemen.
Huh? I've had something else. Something very big was planned for tomorrow night, but has been canceled because you seized the truck load of heroin. You have to be very careful, Michael. I'll try to find out more.
Tomorrow night.
Yeah, tomorrow.
What about tonight?
Tonight?
Yeah, tonight, now, tonight.
Why?
Well, I don't know why. I have no reason.
There's no reason for love and every reason for love.
Who said that?
My father.
Well, you should always listen to what your father says. The truck we got was full of heroin, just like you said it would be. You shouldn't stay here. It's too dangerous.
But you didn't find the lab.
No, but we will. Ortega's questioning the driver right now. I'm laying odds by tomorrow morning we'll know where the lab is, and you shouldn't stay here. It's a little dangerous.
I had to know what happened.
Still, it's a little,
What's that?
Dangerous.
The deaf Chicago cop is worried about me, huh?
Well, yeah, a little bit.
That's nice. No one has worried about me for a long time. Thanks.
Sorry.
Look at you. You have a kind face when you smile. You should do it more often.
I'll try to remember that. Who is it?
It's Joey. Mike, we may have a problem.
We can trust him after all. Let's cut him down.
It was very good of you to come. I know your schedules were full.
Quite right, Mr. Morgan. But President Torres insisted, as a gesture of friendship. After all, cooperation is vital to everyone's national interests.
See when I tell you that.
Thank you.
Lieutenant Torello. Welcome.
Thank you, Minister. Thank you for taking the time to see me.
Yes. May I introduce my assistant, Maria Flores.
How do you do?
My pleasure. Are you enjoying your visit?
We're not here on vacation. This is my partner, Sergeant Danny Krychek.
Nice to meet you, Sergeant.
I'll get right to the point, Minister. I won't take up too much of your time. We think that you have a major problem with Ray Luca here in your country.
I don't understand.
Well, if you don't know who and what Ray Luca is, I'll take the time to clue you in, and then I'll take him off your hands.
No, we can hardly ask Senor Luca to leave the country. He's a great benefactor.
Yes, he's good for our country, for commerce. He brings in business, gives our people jobs. And he's building a new container facility at the port, agricultural facilities in the rainforest.
But it's all a cover-up, don't you understand that?
Lieutenant, forgive me. We know there are problems here, but we have no proof that Senor Luca is involved.
Well, we'd like to look into that ourselves.
How can we allow you to do that?
By you saying yes. I don't care how many improvements Luca makes here. I don't care how many factories he builds for you. The truth is simple. You're letting a major drug dealer operate out of your country.
He's going to run a very large airmail cartel from here. He'll be very powerful, and he'll try to run your country for you.
Oh, really?
Yes, really. And when he's through, he's going to strip the country bare and ship the big money right out of here.
That's ridiculous.
No, it's the truth.
The truth, Lieutenant, is we control our own destiny, not Ray Luca. And not you. We don't let other countries' policemen do whatever they want. I will hear no more of this. Good day to you both.
You guys are a long way from Kansas, no?
Chicago by way of Las Vegas.
Well, I'm Sonia, and this is my place. Welcome.
Hello, Sonia.
You guys cops?
How can you tell?
Well, we get two kinds of people on this place.
Hey, boy.
Welcome to Latin America, Torello.
You're getting too much sun, Ray. Getting all burnt up. You're starting to look like a prune.
Let me guess. This is a warrant for my arrest and extradition. David?
I'm sure they're in order. There's just one thing.
There's no one thing about it. Pack a bag, Struts.
Hey, Torello. I guess you were in a hurry to come here from the airport, huh? You didn't stop at the embassy?
Ambassador Morgan, he was going to tell you.
This country's extradition treaty with the United States has been suspended. Mr. Luca's going nowhere.
Call Ambassador Morgan. I'll tell you the same thing.
Call him.
I'm afraid he's right, Lieutenant Morgan.
I can go anywhere, anytime I want, but I like it here. Now get out of here, Torello, before I have Santos arrest you for trespassing.
Mr. Ambassador, I didn't come all of this way to lay on a beach.
Lieutenant, if you'd only listened to Jenkins, this entire embarrassing episode could have been avoided.
Who cares about being embarrassed?
I do. And as long as I represent the best interests of our country here, you'll listen to me.
I'm a policeman, not a diplomat.
Yeah, well, you policemen made the trip for nothing because you can't have Ray Luca. He told you the truth. Colonel Dance is dead.
With the help of some of his friends.
It's not important what you think. What matters is preserving a strong relationship with President Torres. He's the first head of state in a lifetime that's lasted more than a month. And he's taken a firm stand against the rebels.
Look,
so we need his support.
I don't care about all of that stuff. All I care about is Ray Luca. Now, what about it?
Ray Luca's a guest in this country.
Come on, this guest is an international gangster, a drug dealer, an illegal arms merchant, and every other damn thing.
In the big picture, Luca's inconsequential. To these people here, he's a legitimate businessman. I've instructed Jenkins to make arrangements for your departure. You'll be leaving in the morning, so I suggest you get some rest.
Hold on one minute. I am not going anywhere. And if you don't listen to me, I'll go right to the president.
Out of the question.
Well, then who's the chief cop around here?
For the Minister of the Interior, Esteban.
Well, then I'm going to see him.
But you can't. There's protocol. There's...
Listen, Mr. Ambassador, either you arrange for a meeting or I'm going to do something to really embarrass you. Believe me when I tell you that.
Oh,
wrong question.
Pregunta equivocada.
Traidor! Cerdo! Perro!
Like Maria's tip was right on the nose.
We're a little late.
We have been watching them for months. This meeting gave us the opportunity we had been waiting for.
How did you learn of the meeting?
We had an agent buried deep in their organization.
Colonel Santos, congratulations. We were just wondering if it's a custom in your country for dope dealers to get together for Sunday afternoon picnics.
Our American friends had come to show us how to rid our country of drug dealers. Capitan Ortega, listen carefully. I'm sure Lieutenant Torello will have many suggestions for you. Vámonos.
Wait, is that the same Ortega Maria told us about?
We're gonna find out. Let's go. Thank you for coming. I hear that you're an honest man.
From whom you hear that?
That's my business. Are you an honest man?
Why would I risk coming here?
Thank you.
Listen, Santos was lying. We had no informant among those drug dealers.
It's obvious that Luca had him killed. It's his style. He doesn't like competition.
What can I do for you?
You can help me eliminate Luca one way or another.
Just like that, huh?
Now, if it was just like that, he'd already be a memory. Salud.
Salud.
Local cuisine, Mr. Luca?
Hey, boss. I don't know what they call this, but it's still a steak. And I'll tell you something, it's plenty tough.
You want to fly home so you can have a cheeseburger?
No. I guess this is just fine.
Esteban, I'd like to make Maria an offer. How would you like to come work for me, Maria?
That's a good idea. You're a lot better looking than I am.
I'm afraid Maria is much too loyal to leave me. Hey, Maria.
How about if I pay you twice what Esteban is paying you?
What makes you think I can be back?
Is she kidding?
Do you know, Mr. Luca? Sometimes I feel like I am already working for you.
Maybe you are. What's with Torello?
I have been informed that President Torres has not yet taken action to expel Torello and his friends.
What can I do, Senor Luca? Escort Torello out of this country myself? Would you like me to declare a national emergency?
What is he, comedian?
Oiga, me torna de un chiste, oyo?
Senor Luca, you run a business, but I run a country. How would it look in your newspapers if I expelled Lieutenant Torello?
I don't care how it looks. I want him out now.
Boss, not now. Not now.
Huh?
Buenos días.
What do you want?
The same thing as you, Lieutenant. I am a U.S. Customs agent.
Get all the way out again?
Yes. Girl checks out. Says she's been a custom agent for about a year.
A year? See, for a professional, undercover work is dangerous. But for a rookie, this is a hell of an assignment.
Why's she doing it, Mike?
I asked her. She told me to mind my own business. I don't care what Hallahan says. We absolutely do not trust anybody down.
I want to make something clear. These badges may mean something in this country. But when you hit Latin America, you are on your own.
It's the way we like it.
Winter.
Yeah, I'd like to have the soft drink monopoly in this country.
I'd settle for a six-pack, a hammock, and an ocean breeze.
The flight was a little bumpy.
Wasn't exactly a luxury liner. Look, we're supposed to see Colonel Santos at the security police.
Not now. I got a message from Ambassador Morgan. He wants to see you ASAP.
We'll see Santos first. We'll play politics later, okay? Please, Santos first, all right?
How much foreign aid we pouring into this country?
Millions.
Yeah, where's it going? I bet you Luca doesn't live like this.
No, he lives in the lap of luxury.
Not for long, he won't. All the paperwork on Luca is in order.
Esteban is waiting for me.
Why are you doing this?
It's my business.
When me and my guys take risks based on information that you provide, it becomes my business.
All right. All right, Michael. When my father was the finance minister of this country, he tried to do the right thing for our people. But Esteban had him killed. I should have killed Esteban a long time ago. But I couldn't do it. I can't do it. So, I will do what I have to do to stop him. Up to and including sleeping with him, if that's what it takes. Nada más. Fíjate que me dieron una botella de champán, pero si no es francesa, no puedo. Oh, no, 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 la amiga, es la hermana de la...
Sí, tiene alcohol.
Ay, no, ¿te gusta el tequila? No te gusta.
Good evening, Mr. President. It's a fine evening, isn't it?
What is this, Lieutenant? What do you think you're doing?
Oh, we're burning some heroin that was being smuggled out of your country before we got to it. Thanks to the fine cooperation of Colonel Santos and the police. This bonfire is a testimonial to our joint effort on the war on drugs. Would you like to come down and see it?
Oh, no, no. You prove your point.
Yes, we did, Mr. President.
I got that one.
Great stuff. Great stuff.
You guys cops?
How can you tell?
Well, we get two kinds of people in this place, either cops or crooks. Now this one has an honest face. But the rest of you guys, I hate Chihuahua.
I hate Chihuahua. Wow. Figured out what we're gonna do about Luca yet, Mike?
I still like plan B. Shoot him.
And move into his house.
Keep the girls.
Not spaghetti and meatballs, huh?
Nah.
I'll tell you what we're gonna do. What we're gonna do is discover the location of his lab, and then we're gonna destroy his entire drug operation.
That sounds great. Mm. How are we gonna do that?
I have absolutely no idea.
Do you like our local cuisine, Mr. Luca?
Hey, boss. I don't know what they call this, but it's still a steak. And I'll tell you something, it's plenty tough.
You want to fly home so you can have a cheeseburger?
No. I guess this is just fine.
Esteban, I'd like to make Maria an offer. How would you like to come work for me, Maria?
That's a good idea. He's a lot better looking than I am.
I'm afraid Maria is much too loyal to leave me. Hey, Maria.
How about if I pay you twice what Esteban is paying you?
What makes you think I can be bad?
Is she kidding?
Do you know, Mr. Luca? Sometimes I feel like I am already working for you.
But you are. What's with Torello?
I have been informed that President Torres has not yet taken action to expel Torello and his friends.
Torello out of this country myself, would you like me to declare a national emergency?
What is he, a comedian? Oiga, me torna de un chiste, oyó?
Señor Luca, you run a business, but I run a country. How would it look in your newspapers if I expelled Lieutenant Torello?
I don't care how it looks. I want him out now.
Boss, not now. Not now.
Winter.
Yeah, I'd like to have the soft drink monopoly in this country.
I'd settle for a six-pack, a hammock, and an ocean breeze.
Flight was a little bumpy.
Wasn't exactly a luxury liner. Look, we're supposed to see Colonel Santos at the security police.
Not now. I got a message from Ambassador Morgan. He wants to see you ASAP.
We'll see Santos first. We'll play politics later, okay?
Lieutenant.
Please, Santos first, all right?
much foreign aid we pouring into this country?
Millions.
Yeah, where's it going? Bet you Luca doesn't live like this.
No, he lives in the lap of luxury.
Not for long, he won't. All the paperwork on Luca is in order, Colonel. We had the extradition papers and the warrant cleared through your embassy before we left the States.
Yes? I see no problem, Mr. Torello.
Lieutenant Torello.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant Torello. When would you like to serve this?
Right away. Luca's gotten away from us before. We'd like to get him on a plane and back to the States tomorrow.
Okay. Then let's go. This way, gentlemen.
I don't want to know about what you can't do. Those planes leave Hong Kong, monsoon or not. Yeah. Yeah, and listen. You get me Chen in Geneva. Tell him to call me at about 2 o'clock my time. Put her in a hammerlock,
fella. Good boy. Welcome to Latin America, Torello.
You're getting too much sun, Ray. Getting all burnt up. You're starting to look like a prune.
Let me guess. This is a warrant for my arrest and extradition. David?
I'm sure they're in order. There's just one thing.
There's no one thing about it. Pack a bag, Struts.
Hey, Torello. I guess you were in a hurry to come here from the airport, huh? You just stop at the embassy?
Ambassador Morgan, he was going to tell you.